What's going on, everybody? It's the Hook Cam back again with another film breakdown. This time we're taking a look at the Monday night game between the Browns and the Niners. You know, really looking at are the Niners legit? Are the Browns not legit? What really went down on Monday? I specifically look at the Niners running game, some of the binds that they put the Browns in as far as with Kyle Juszczyk, the blocking from George Kittle, the blocking up front. You know, Shanahan is an outstanding young coordinator and head coach, and really a huge fan of what he's doing offensively, so we really dive into that. And then also defensively, we take a look at some of the pressures that the Niners are bringing, coverage-wise, what they're doing, and why they were able to really throttle the Browns on Monday night. So that's going to be the entirety of this video. I hope you guys enjoy. If you do, please drop a like, hit that subscribe button. It would be greatly appreciated from me. It's helping me grow the channel, and I really appreciate any and all support I can get from you guys. So with that being said, let's dive into this thing, and I hope you enjoy the video. All right, fellas, first play we're taking a look at here from this Niners masterpiece. You know, something that the Niners do and that people were pointing out is the motioning of their fullback, right? 44 Kyle Juszczyk, one of the most utilized players in the NFL, and I also think one of the most underrated. I think that he is hands down one of the best players in the NFL at his position, and I don't think that's disputed. We'll see throughout this game. They line him up at tight end. They line him up at fullback. They line to split him out at receiver. He does a ton for these guys. So all that we're getting from this play is inside zone to the right with a wham. That's it. It's really not that crazy of a play when you sit there and look at it schematically. But the 49ers have the Browns in a bind off the bat. First things first, because we only got two backers in here. Okay, this is nickel. And people want to talk about, oh, the base defenses should be a nickel now. There shouldn't be more than two. No, that's not true. Okay, your base defense should, if you're in a 3-4, it's going to have four backers, some sort of edge rusher. Obviously, if you're in a 4-3, you're going to have your three backers who are run-stopping, gap-defending backers who can move all over the place. Right now, you're in a nickel against 21 personnel, and you're in a bind off the bat. Okay, so what they're going to do is they're going to run inside zone with the offensive line. I know I'm rambling now, but they're going to run inside zone with the offensive line. They do a great job working their combos. Okay, he's working out on this end. These two are going to work out to here. Okay, to 42. Are my left guard and left tackle are going to work from here up to 51. This is the unblocked guy, which is kind of a mistake from the 49ers, but because of this motion, it bumps him over. Right, see how it bumps him over just a little bit, and now this looks like wide zone. This is an outstanding play call. This is an outstanding play design. This looks like wide zone to these backers. They're thinking, I got to fill to my edge, I got to fill to my gap, I got to fill in this backside window. Not a chance, man. We're running inside zone to the left off of this. Okay, really good job from Juszczyk getting downhill, right, getting far downhill, so that way he's coming right off of the lineman's feet, and then he's working basically to a cut. I love that they can do this in the NFL. You can't do this in high school. I think you can do it in college as well, but he throws this cut here, not a chance for 54, and then George Kittle with a great block on the safety coming upfield. And that's kind of one of the things I want to highlight with this is watch 85's block on this, right? He steps down into his gap, checks to see if there's any threat here. Now, if this backer had bumped over, then Kittle would be on him and this combo would be working to the mic. But since this mic is up in the wash, there's no chance he's getting there. Kittle moves his eyes back to that safety, works to cut that guy off, doesn't need a big block, just a quick chip on him. And Matt Breida's off to the races, fellas, for a big time play for the Niners, making a statement on this Monday night game, but just a beautifully designed play from the Shanahan offense to start things off. All right, really quickly, fellas, this really wasn't even in my notes that I wanted to talk about. One of my biggest pet peeves is sending a tight end to block a pass rusher or an edge rusher, whatever the hell you want to call it. It's one of my biggest pet peeves in football, because this is going to happen to you almost every time. Unless you've got a stud who knows how to pass block, this is going to happen. I don't understand why teams keep doing this. They keep, okay, we're going to bring a tight end in to help with the protection. Yeah, absolutely, but that doesn't mean that you can slide the rest of your offensive line away and act like this dude's a six-year, $60 million left tackle. I mean, you're setting this guy up for failure. I don't understand why teams do this, right? Nick Bosa does exactly what you need to. Just over-physical him, you long-arm him, you get inside closest path to a quarterback, and you shut this thing down before it even has a chance. I don't understand why teams do this. This is just my little blurb schematically for what are teams doing when they bring in a tight end to help with the protection, but don't give your tight end help. It doesn't help with the protection to make it a six-man pro if you're going to leave him one-on-one with a stud pass rusher. Doesn't make sense to me. Anyway, great pressure from Bosa, forces the pick, easy ball for 25 to pick off on that. But I digress. Just one of the things that I don't understand about the NFL today. All right, fellas, third down and 7 here for the Cleveland Browns. Really, really cool fire zone that we're going to see from the 49ers. So just really quickly, coverage-wise, whenever you're running a fire zone, okay, you're obviously getting pressure here from the left side of the defense. So you're going to roll this safety down, roll this one back, drop this one into coverage, and it essentially becomes like a cover 3 that you pressure into. Up top, you're just going to be locked up because it's one-on-one, and you're not going to drop him and let him just pick up easy yardage, right? But you're going to roll with these two safeties, drop this one into a deep third, and then he, I guess, essentially would have this half of the field. But again, you're trying to pressure before anybody gets there. But what's interesting about this pressure from the 49ers, and what I'm starting to see out of teams in the NFL, is one of these dudes on the line that's away from the 3-by receiver side, he's going to drop and get in front of number 3. Okay, so obviously we get pressure from that left side. I'll break that down when we go end zone view, right? But 55 is going to drop, and he's going to stay in front of whoever that number 3 is. Now, he takes the deep guy. You can see here that he's trying to come back because he's supposed to stay in front of number 3, who's shallow. Because ideally, if you get pressure here, right, quarterbacks don't have enough time to sit there and go, oh, they're dropping, I got to get this ball. They're going to say, where's my blitz beater? I got to hit my blitz beater right now, which would ideally be this under. Right, but we're dropping this dude who's on the opposite side of the number 3 receiver, of the 3-by receiver side. Okay, just something that's really interesting. When I was watching the Bills Patriots last week, the Bills did this a ton. I think it's going to get picked up in the NFL and done way more. I don't even know if the Bills are the first team to do it, honestly. It's just something that I noticed. Now, getting into this pressure that we see from the 49ers, really, really cool job from this. Okay, if the Browns are going to line up receivers tight, then we're going to have these corners who are going to be involved with the pressure. So here's what's happening on this. Okay, we're getting just a straight up rush from 98 out here. 55, he's the one who's going to drop and get in front of whoever the new number 3 is. Okay, we're getting pressure from our nose. Our Mike is going to stem inside into this gap and bring pressure here. Technically our Will, I guess this would actually technically be the Mike, this would be the Will. So this Mike is going to get upfield in between this B gap, and then we're bringing pressure outside here with Bosa. But the key to this pressure is this the blitz we bring from the corner, right? This blitz we bring from the corner seals this thing off. Okay, good job from the Niners mixing this thing up. As far as bringing pressure away from the back, it's always harder for a back to get across the formation and make contact with a backer who just gives it to him. What a play by 56. That was awesome. This kid plays physical as hell. I'll show you guys another play later in the game. But love the pressure the Niners bring here, bringing in that nickel back as well. Really good job, man. They had 6 swimming on Monday night. Outstanding job from that defensive coordinator and that defensive front as a whole. All right, fellas, a first down and 10 here for the 49ers. All we're going to get is a motion out of our tight end over to this side of the formation, right? And all we have here is 22 personnel out of the Niners, okay? Just watch what the motion does to the backers, though. Look at the mass confusion that it's causing these guys. This should not happen for a pro defense. It really shouldn't. We've even got confusion down here for who's going to be over the tight end. We don't even know. Now, I get that that's George Kittle, and he's going to have a lot of attention toward him, but you should know what you're doing defensively in this situation. You should know whether or not, yeah, we're going to roll a guy down, we're going to have our edge play tight on him, friction him off the line. You should know what's going on, okay? All that being said, here's what the 49ers run, okay? All the running is counter off of this, all right? So blocking-wise, here's what's going to happen. My tight end is going to work up to 57 here. He's going to work up to pin him inside on this thing. We want to take counter and run this A-gap to outside. Okay, we're going to get a combo from our left guard and left tackle working up to 53. We're back blocking on the nose tackle here from the center. Obviously, we're going to get a backside hinge out of both of our backside guys. And we're pulling, open pulling down the line of scrimmage, kicking out this edge defender. And then with our fullback, we're taking counter steps, working up to 38. Really well executed out of the 49ers. And that's one of the things that I love about this, right? Great kick out from 68. Really good job from Juszczyk working up onto that that safety who's really down in the box. And this is one of the things that the Niners do to you, man. They're going to line up in 22 personnel. They're going to force you to play hard-nosed football against them because they're going to run the rock. They got 3 running backs who they trust and they believe in to run the football and run it well, run it physically. They're going to wear you down in a game. I love this brand of football. Niners played an outstanding game as far as running the rock goes, which we'll get into a little bit later. But again, first and 10 coming out in 22 personnel. Have you learned from your mistakes from the opening possession when we came out in this and you over pursued with your backers? Yeah, they do, but still they're picking up 6 yards on this. An outstanding double team, by the way. Outstanding double team by our, I believe that's left guard and left tackle, who are just mashing this dude into the ground. Look at that. That's great, man. You'd like to see this guard be able to work up to the second level, but the physicality of this tackle makes everything all right. Really good job out of those two. But again, counter on first and 10, man. I love the way the Niners play this brand of football. It's awesome. All right, fellas, all we're going to have on this play is the Baker Mayfield strip sack. Really quickly, just coverage-wise, what the Niners are doing. Once the Browns motion out and they go to empty, it looks to me like the Niners drop into a cover four look. Just really trying to drop back, make sure nothing be too deep, take anything in front of you. I think there is a slight mistake by 54 trying to get all the way across here. I think he should stay and pass that thing off. But all that being said, let's take a look at this pass rush because that's really what makes this play. Nick Bosa, okay, just an outstanding job by this young man on this one, okay? Running upfield, really trying to get this tackle, right? Cam Robinson, he's trying to force him to think, hey, I'm beating you to a point. This is going to be a speed rush. I'm going to drop my shoulder, work that edge right around you, right? Gets to a point and then gives this dude a nice little a pass by, a swim almost. I think they call it a pin swipe in the NFL. I believe that's the term that they use. Could change from team to team, but again, that gives him that pin swipe, gets right inside. Now, the key to this pass rush move, for those of you wondering at home, is his inside hand gets to the elbow of 78. That's the big deal here, because as 78 goes to punch, see how that arm's on his elbow, right? Pushing that thing right by, the swim over the top. That's really what starts the pressure in this, okay? So 6, as he drops back, he feels that, right? Good job from him feeling that, oh, My left tackle just got worked on this. Now, on the other side of this pass rush, we're going to have a nice, a really good twist out of these two. Really good twist, okay? My end is going to stem inside. See how he works in between this gap, and he almost just kind of stops right while he gets kind of pinballed. But not that he stops, but he attracts the attention of both of these guys, 74 and 72. Now, 91 does a good job kind of hesitating, engaging, and then trying to get outside of this. Right, and this really goes exactly how you want it from a Niners coaches and fans perspective. We get the pressure from 97 that works 6 to his right, and it works him right into this twist. Okay, really good job here. 6 is nothing he can do. Of course, the strip sack and the recovery, just an outstanding job from the Niners on this play. But just you can kind of see mentality, you know, thought process wise, what's going on in the defensive coordinator's head when they're calling these. Obviously, this is picture perfect. It doesn't usually work out like this, but the pass rush from 97 kicks this thing off, and then the twist from 91 and 55 brings this one home. Really good job from the Niners on this play. All right, guys, we got a big fourth down and one for the 49ers on this. Just watch the motion from number 11 coming across the field and then bringing it across here. All we're trying to do with that is, number one, create the smoke and mirrors, widen these two out. That's kind of the initial reaction from this. Now, what you're doing with 11 running this way, take care of that flat defender, and hopefully you pull another backer over there as well. See how we're creating the hesitation between these two, okay? That's what's going on with that motion. You're just trying to create hesitation, make the defense second guess themselves. Think about what they're doing. What's their responsibility? This dude's going to be the flat defender on this play. So why have him involved in this? Because all you're running inside of this is power, right? But you show them this flat, this threat to the flat here, and it takes away this backer and this corner, I guess, on this play. Now, getting into the nitty gritty on this thing, taking a look at what the Niners actually run, it's just power. There's nothing too crazy about this play besides the motion, right? Niners are lining up here, and really it's 12 personnel just because who's on the field. 82 and 85 are both tight ends. Obviously, Tevin Coleman's the running back on this play, but the motion across, right? It bumps these linemen down as well. Okay, so now we're just thinking straight gap defense with this, trying to hold your gap, hold your gap, hold your gap. And then we've got these two up over the top to really work anything that bounces outside, right? But what we're going to get on this is essentially just big boy football, down block, down block, down block. And then we're working upfield with 85, who's supposed to kick out anything. Now, what I like about this is that he steps down into his gap. Excuse me, 85's not kicking out. 82 ideally would be the kick out guy in this. Steps down into his gap, 85 does, and then works up to that backer. Really, we get a good old-fashioned 3-on-1 with that. But what should ideally happen, okay? As that receiver motions across, we bump down with our defensive line. 85 steps down, he's taking anything that steps into this C gap. That's his job. 82 is working here. He's working outside of him into this D gap. Power is a gap scheme play. Everybody is gap responsible. So as 82 works out here, he's looking for that kick out defender. Now there is none. Right? Not only is there no kick out guy, but 22 is just standing here flat footed. So you know what 82 says? I'm not going to go waste a body on him. I'm not going to. I know power's an A-gap play. I know we need to hit this thing inside, and he works up and he helps out his boy on 53 here, because that's the true threat, right? See how he checked his eyes here, and now he's working up? Really good job on that. Okay, why waste a body out here? No, we're going to go and we're going to triple team this dude and for sure pick up this first down. Now, the other thing I love about this is the pull from 75, okay? A really good job on this pull, getting around, getting upfield, and again, we're just trying to locate and mash this dude and pick up some easy yardage for a first down. All right, now, I love the physicality of the down blocks as well. That's really what makes power, okay, is these down blocks. And this isn't even really a big physical down block. It's just the fact that it's effective. 95's got no chance to make that play. Really good play call from the Niners. I love the smoke and mirrors, but then at the same time, I love the simplicity of it, okay, and the discipline from these Niner offensive linemen, tackles, and running backs on this play. Just a really good job of execution in general and as a whole from the Niners offense on this one. All right, the play after that first down run from the 49ers, we're going to get essentially a buck sweep out of these guys for a touchdown, okay? Now, very, very easy to block, very easy to figure out schematically. All we're going to get is a down block from 83. We're going to get a down block from our left tackle. We're going to pull with our left guard and our center out here. Now, our left guard is looking to kick out right away because we got this backer down on the line. Okay, and then our center, just an outstanding job by the center on this play. Really good job. As soon as we get that kick out, ideally that's what it is. He ends up kind of hooking him, but the center takes this thing inside. Just a phenomenal job from this group and as a whole. Okay, now the key to this, though, and I'm going to run this from the wide so you can see it. The key is this receiver. Okay, so we're getting down blocks across the line, right? Down block, down block. We're pulling here to kick out this edge defender. We're pulling and working inside of that kick out with the center, and he's going to take the corner. I know what you're thinking. Well, what about the safety, coach? Okay, we got the receiver coming down to dig that thing out. Just an outstanding job by this cat. Look at as he works down. Your safety's got no idea. Takes that thing on, and that to me is what really opens this up. Now, is it effective? No, he kind of gets blown back a little bit. Is it physical? No, he kind of gets blown back. But it is effective. Safety doesn't make the play. Therefore, it's an effective block. Really good job by 26 working this thing upfield. But again, I just wanted to show that receiver because it's tough to find receivers that block, right? In the NFL, not as much because guys, obviously, they want to be on a team. But college, high school, it's tough to find receivers that want to block, right? Really good vision by 26. Great job by that receiver coming in and making a play on that. And then taking this thing to the pylon, Tevin Coleman, putting the Niners in front big time in this first half. But again, just a really good job of execution. And, you know, another unsung hero on this play that I need to point out is 68. Because this reach block on a nose tackle, very difficult to do. But he works all the way in front, gets his hips in front, gets his butt towards the running back, and is able to sit on that thing. So there's really no threat from the running back. But again, the execution from the 49ers when it comes to running the rock is next level. And it's making them one of the better teams in the NFL. I have no problem saying that. All right, fellas, we're going to take a look at kind of the physicality that's being brought by both teams. All right, now we're going to get a wide zone to the left out of the Browns. All right, now two guys that I want to watch on this play. Number one is number 91 over here, and the other one's 56. 91 on this play does a great job knifing in, right, getting to the inside and working across to get to 24. That's an outstanding job. That's pure hustle, pure effort. He could get cut off, and it would kill it wouldn't kill the play. It would make the play, really. But a really good job from 91 working across. Great job from Bosa setting the edge over here. But the other guy that I want to watch is 56 because 56 brings the heat. And this is a man's play by 56. He works up and absolutely gives it to 72 and is in on the tackle. Right now, one of my knocks on the Browns going into this season was their offensive line. I just hadn't seen enough out of them yet. And 56, this is pure physicality, right? 72, what are you doing on this? Okay, this is wide zone to the left. You need to get your feet moving. You got to work up to 56, get on him, and make sure he's not in on the play. And he just gets worked on this thing, man. That is getting your lunch given to you. taken away from you, whatever you want to say. It is a physical play by 56 on this, and it really just kind of epitomized the night to me from the Niners' perspective. They were ready to play. They were more physical. They had this Browns team scouted up, and they knew everything that was coming. They knew the tendencies. They knew what was going to happen, but they also were able to make the plays and get it done because they were more physical of a football team. That's the way that I look at this. But again, just an outstanding job for 56 and 91, the two guys in on that play. And then we got Bosa down here, and he does a really good job of setting the edge on this thing, okay? And you can see, and I believe that he's trying to give a little hand to the back here, saying, hey, I'm going to just kind of work this thing upfield, so you got to take it inside of that. Does that make sense? So with wide zone, really there's one of two things you can do as a tackle. You can try and work to get to this edge so we can pop this thing out as a running back, or you're just going to kind of work them upfield and we're cutting it up inside, right? I kind of believe that he's telling him, hey, I'm just going to work this thing up inside. That's what I think it is. Who knows, though? Anyway, just the physicality from the Niners defense really was the epitome of the night to me, and it's really summed up on this play. All right, fellas, last play we're taking a look at here. It's going to be a 3rd and 10 for the Browns, and I just really want to hit again on the pressure that the Niners were bringing during this game. So remember earlier in the game, we saw one of the down backers or two-point stance linemen really dropped in front of number 3. That's what we're going to get again here from 54. Watch how we bring pressure. He steps back. He's a little too deep, but he's staying in front of number 3. That's his job. A really good job by him, not getting too deep, and when he does, of working back to get more shallow on it. We're really just getting a cover one look from everybody else, just straight up man. Now, here's my theory with this cat, okay, because obviously he's not manned up with anybody. And he's not in the middle of the field enough for me to say it's a true cover one. I think that he's looking down this way in almost a robber sense, okay? Because I think that if this backer gets too deep and they run underneath and complete this pass to the flat, I think he's supposed to be the guy that's going to come up and make a play on that. If they complete this dig, which they're trying to hit here, he's going to come up and make a play on that. But he is deep enough for me to say cover one. So to be honest, I'm not 100% sure. But let's take a look at this thing from the pressure side of it, okay? Now, 54 is going to be the guy that drops into coverage in front of that new number 3. All right, what we're going to get on the right side of the line is we're going to get a rush from 55 upfield. We're going to get a rush from 91 into this B gap. And then from 99, I believe, we're going to get a rush across the face of the nose tackle. And that's going to really open up some gaps here on the right side of the line. And then we're also going to get pressure from this nickelback, and that's really the guy who's going to force the hand from Baker on this, right? And again, just this Browns offensive line cannot hold up against the Niners pass rush. It really can't. But just an outstanding job across the board here. Bosa working upfield, collapsing that edge from 55. I mean, talk about a pass rush move. I believe that's D Ford coming over from Kansas City. But a really good job here, just beating 74 to a point. I mean, he's got no shot on that. Good job from the nickelback bringing that pressure. But again, just showing you guys the creativity from the Niners. This is really the same pressure that we saw early in the game. The only difference is that we're stemming this nose across, and it's a different guy dropping in front of number 3. Okay? But just the creativity from the Niners in general really just smoked the Browns, gave 6 nothing to work with. To be honest, I don't think it's all Baker's fault. I know a lot of people are speaking bad things about Baker. I liked him coming out of college. But I don't really think that this is all his fault. You have to have more stuff built into your offense to help out your quarterback, right? He's got nothing right now. I mean, and look what we're running up top. You have no other dig or anything underneath it, right? Stem this guy upfield and run a dig. I don't know. Hindsight's always 20/20 with football. But anyway, all that stuff being said, guys, I'm the Hook Cam. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I enjoyed breaking it down from the Niners' perspective. Haven't done a breakdown on them in a little bit. If you guys did enjoy, please hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. It would help me greatly trying to grow this channel into something a little bit bigger. So with all that being said, guys, I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you next time.